we're all lost, and that's a thing that, well, should be discussed with us, architects, urbanists, planners, but also policymakers and probably everybody. So as a festival, we thought that should be this year's theme, Lost in Transition.
An hour before we opened the debate, there was the first review online by Arginet. In fact, what I picked up on that and I really enjoyed in screening, obviously I saw the movie before we met, was that you, in fact, have, let's say, a double standard, a double binary. You're part of the problem or not. And what she mentions is that you do not ride the moral high ground with this movie. In fact, you examine the complexities.
The problem is, if you deal with the problems of the city, there is never a solution, because as the city is a very complex place, is moving all the time, is interacting with so many things, you just try to ease certain things, and you have to find new solutions for small problems the whole time. But there is no such thing as the perfect city where you find the final solution for the housing, the gentrification, and the urbanism problems.
The challenge that we have is to find a new type of development model, which is about degrowth, which is about sustainability, which is about inclusivity.
I still really believe that Europe is the place where we do have space, where we do have the capacity of absorbing mass immigration.
How do you deal with this question? Am I part of a gentrification strategy, non-knowingly or aggressively?
People actually know green is like a red light, actually. It's like, because green means gentrification.
5 points. Number one, the city is a place that is constantly in transition. This is the character of city. You can't freeze a neighborhood. It will always change. Number two, if we discuss about gentrification, urbanization, how we could change processes, etc., etc., always keep in mind it takes at least 20 years until these things are really and really there. Number three, if you really dig into it, the steering mechanisms of urbanization, of building houses, of gentrification are super complex. There are laws on several levels, and this makes it so difficult, and this makes it also a bit ridiculous when someone like me comes and says, do this or do that. Number four, important is to see if you dislike gentrification, that there are places like Detroit or cities in the east of Germany that are really very bad. And so you can say what is worse than gentrification? It's if you have no gentrification at all. And the last point would just be, get involved, do something, you can make a difference.